Can you cook fish balls with an air fryer? Watch this! Hi, I'm Marco, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to have a fish balls party. But first, we have to cook the fish balls and the kik yam in the air fryer. I have some fish balls here and some kik yam. Now we put them inside the air fryer. Then close it. Then turn it on. After 5 minutes, voila! My fish balls party is ready! Abracadabra! Shing!
It is hands down one of the greatest soups that has ever been created by a human being. Correct? Uncle loves Tom Yum, but I wish Uncle Joshua would buy tripod. Don't. Let's prepare our tamarind. The tamarind, correct, for 90 grams of tamarind, 820 milliliters of boiling hot water. Stir it and let it sit for a few minutes. Stir again until smooth and pass it through a mesh strainer. To cook, we have an aspect. Good use of colander. Pass through and nothing else will. And, well, that's it. And, ooh, look at that. So smooth. That pace smoother than Nephew Nigel, DMA. Get a nice wok and add 1 1/4 wok. Good. Boil good. To boil. And actually, wait, let me preface the next bit. We're doing the following recipe pretty much 100% in grains. We're doing the following recipe pretty much 100% in grains.
Scram? Why use scram? The only unit Asian people use is feeling.
Before heating that oil, add 50 grams of garlic, good, peeled and thinly sliced, cook, and let that bad boy naturally come up. First the garlic will start to bubble, then fry, and
why he dancing in the background? Focus, focus, don't multitask, dancing while cooking. Burning calorie while creating calorie.
Let that bad boy cook. Stir it occasionally until the garlic is toasted and golden brown. Remove from the oil, place on a paper towel to drain. Next, add 100 grams of peeled and thinly sliced shallots.
Shallot correct.
And they're a nice golden brown. Quickly remove them from the oil and drain on a paper towel.
Ah, looks so nice. Look at both the shallot and garlic together. Fuyo! That must smell so good. Shallot and garlic, Uncle Roger's favorite smell. I should bottle up that smell. Make perfume. Call it all the Uncle Roger.
Drain on a paper towel. Last, you'll add 50 grams of chili.
Chili good?
Or arbol chilies. Jelly stir those and fry for about 20 seconds. Or until fragrant and beginning to darken. Remove and drain yet again.
See? He used so many chili. That good? Many white people chef always put too few chili in. Then remember when it comes to
the mixture. And well, that's it. One.
Nice, look good. Food processor make things so easy. Uncle Roger old now, not enough energy to pound for a long time.
Alright, back to your wok. With the oil from earlier, pop that bad boy on medium heat. Then add your shrimp powder, lightly stir fry till fragrant. 50 grams of palm sugar.
Wait, palm sugar, correct. But why your palm sugar look like rock? Why it not fresh anymore, Uncle Joshua? Get fresh palm sugar. Good palm sugar should be thick, but still spoonable. Thick and spoonable is also what Uncle Roger looking for in me. Uncle Roger haven't spooned for so long now. For Asian cooking, always use palm sugar. White sugar for poor people.
Cook together, stirring constantly until your palm sugar is completely dissolved. Then stir your chili mixture. Your tamarind, good, 90 grams of fish sauce, and just let that simmer, stirring often.
All correct.
Pour that into a bowl and let it
Look good.
Yes, this will make it sing.
Look at that, looks so nice. Every step correct, he Uncle Joshua for a reason. Now it's time. First, get yourself 1.5 pounds of head on shrimp, or eye shrimp. Shrimp good. Remove their heads and shells. Place it.
Remove head. Correct.
And add 2 stalks of lemongrass, sliced, and a 2-inch knob of galangal.
Lemongrass and galangal, okay, but we don't need the cheesecloth. Tom Yum, okay, to just let lemongrass and galangal float on the water. Uncle Joshua, why are you so scared of ingredient floating in soup? Why? Where your courage?
In a small stock pot, add just enough vegetable oil to cook the bottom of the pot. Eat every medium high until
Wait, what?
2 heads of mini pink.
What? No, that's so much mushroom. Mushroom, correct, but that's too much. That is some Jamie Oliver bullshit. Jamie Oliver loves mushroom. That mask is Uncle Roger's best investment so far.
The 2 king oyster mushrooms sliced.
See that? That's so much. Look at this brown. That's so much mushroom. Who are you cooking this tom yum for? Super Mario, is it? Also, Tom in tom yum. Boil. Nothing should be fried like this.
1/4 cup or 80 grams of your non-prick cow from earlier, and 5 cloves of garlic thinly sliced.
No, 5 type. Small mistake. Tom Yum broth don't need garlic. Garlic just for non-prick pop.
Saute that until fragrant.
No more saute. Hiya, Uncle Joshua. Are you Omicron? Because you keep fucking everything up now.
Add in your sachet, then all of your shrimp stock followed by 7 cubic.
Okay.
Then just bring it to lights out. It's all correct again. Cook for 15 minutes. Add your mushrooms back to the pot, then add your peeled and deep baked shrimp from earlier, reduce the heat to low, and
okay, this good enough.
Your shrimp is cooked. Then hit that with 1/4 cup of 50
fish sauce.
Fish sauce.
3 fish sauce good.
38 grams.
Wait, no, lime now? Lime now? Fish sauce, cream of flavor. You use fish sauce, you don't need MSG. But lime, just don't put now. You're still simmering. The heat gonna kill the lime juice. It's not gonna taste like anything. Lime juice you put in there when you turn off heat.
And 3 tablespoons of 42 grams of palm sugar. You better taste
palm sugar good.
And as needed. You know, oftentimes when I make this up by myself,
correct? Always taste while you cook.
Systems. You gotta get that balanced harmony of rich umami saltiness. A fair level of sweetness and a nice zingy
plumpness. So much lime juice. You need so much lime juice because the heat killing the lime flavor.
Unless you have it the right way. Play with it until it tastes.
What? You need more?
Absolutely fantastic. Half punch of cilantro and Thai basil. Just steep in the hot broth just before serving. Get yourself a bowl. Serve it up. I like to add a little bit of the oil from the non-prick cow. Take that bowl.
No need oil. No need extra oil.
Fresh cilantro leaves. Now that was
cilantro garnish, correct?
Perfect. Bowl of tom yum. Given about all the love you deserve. But as soon as I tasted this, it was so goddamn good. It felt like a borderline fancy experience.
What that dish made? Fancy version of tom yum? It's not gonna end well. Probably gonna do some gourmet, wannabe Michelin star restaurant bullshit.
Mr. Mushrooms, brown butter, lobster, scallion pebbles.
Oh, squid bottle. If you go to an Asian restaurant and you see squid bottle, run. That not good Asian restaurant.
Place your lobster tail in the center of the plate. Oh boy, I can already feel the messy coming. Slice the sear mushroom, thick boy, in half lengthwise, plate it alternating, right.
Stop improvising. Don't try to be a genius.
Finally, some fresh cilantro and baby Thai basil leaves.
This look like fish nephew Nigel ordered to impress basic white girl on date. So many people obsessed with making things look like Michelin star. Why we care for Michelin star? Michelin tire company. Hiya. Uncle Roger gonna come up with the Asian version of Michelin star system. Gonna call it the Uncle Roger Orange Polo Award. If you know people who run food or something, why do eggplant always remind you of your pee?
Without further ado, let's get started.
To begin our paste, we're going to first toast off 1 teaspoon of cumin and 1 teaspoon of coriander. Toasting is really going to start to break.
Toasting spices, correct? Toasting spice a lot like checking your privilege. Many white people forget to do it.
Bring out that flavor. And in my opinion, it is a necessary step to make the perfect cut. Now the key to begin, let's grind it.
Hard to solve, good technique for pestle and mortar. And hard to solve is also what Uncle Roger feel when I see nephew Nick in that ugly ass outfit. Sorry, children. Grinding.
Once you've ground it into a fine powder like this, we're ready to add that next ingredient, lemongrass.
Lemongrass, correct?
Now into our mortar, we go with two stalks of chopped lemongrass. Immediately, I'm gonna grind again because of how...
Go see how my big mother-in-law pounds. That's what you need to do.
Now it's time to prep our next view. Here is Galanga. And already have to chop up this. Peel off some of that lovely kaffir lime zest.
Let's go
7 or 8 cloves of garlic.
Got it, good.
And of course, whenever we add garlic or onions, we can't forget to add our blue sauce.
You're not pounding, you just stir. If you think this motion is pounding, then you have to apologize to your girlfriend. If your pounding make no sound, you fucked up. This is nephew, remember, pounding shit. But he go into bedroom and then he just go.
Now it's time to crank up the
green chili.
Good time to go with however many Thai green chilies you want.
Chili, okay. Green color.
And now before we grind that up, we want to go with about a half cup of cilantro stem.
No, not cilantro stem. Authentic Thai green curry, use cilantro root. Cilantro root, very hard to get in Western grocery store. Uncle Roger's so frustrated. Cannot get cilantro root anywhere here in UK. I think I'm gonna escape this country. Be refugee.
Now once we've ground this all off, what you're looking at right here is Thai basil.
Thai basil now?
This is no ordinary basil. This stuff right here is the best of the best basil. I'll go on with one.
Wait, no. Don't put the Thai basil in pestle and mortar. Thai basil go in at the end of cooking. It's not pesto. You're just trying to make pesto now.
Thai basil. Trying to keep out those stems if I can. Then 1/2 cup of these dried kaffir lime leaves.
Kaffir lime leaf, correct. But get better lime leaf. It's so dry. Inside of which pyramid you get this lime leaf from? Did he just eat Indiana Jones into the pyramid? That's the dead pharaoh. And he just steal kaffir lime leaf from them? Why so dry? So dry! That leaf drier than Auntie Helen. How to use?
And finally, to finish off this piece, I'll go with about 5
shallot, correct?
Optionally, just a tiny touch of this shrimp paste.
Shrimp paste, correct? Not optional. Don't be pussy. Eat your shrimp paste.
Easily the least appetizing ingredient we're using today, but just like fish sauce, which we'll add later, it adds depth to the overall flavor of this dish.
So many white people fear shrimp paste. Even him! Look at nothing, Nick! You're so little! Put mushroom paste, never cold.
This right here is the foundation of our recipe, and it is a beautiful, smooth curry paste that we've worked hard to achieve. Now, it's time to let our rice cooker get to work.
Rice cooker?
Good rice first. And here I have the
rinsing rice, correct? Make sure you clean your dirty brain also.
The water brush is clear. Once you've rinsed off that rice, into our rice cooker it goes.
He used same rice cooker as Uncle Roger. See my rice cooker back then? See? Same one, just different color.
To know how much water to add, we'll use the classic finger method.
Finger method.
The first notch on my finger. We know. Now?
Someone been watching all Uncle Roger video. Uncle Roger's so happy.
Time to break down this whole chicken right. To begin, I like to slice it on the skin between each of the legs. Now we can separate off both of those legs.
Oops! Tummy full!